Hola mis maravillosos estudiantes. Hello my wonderful, wonderful students. It is part 6. It's the final part of Lucas and his local beans. We're finally going to get the conclusion of this book. We've got a lot of vocabulary for us to review. As a matter of fact, the second slide that you're going to see in this presentation that I'm sharing with you is going to have all of the words so that we can just simply go back and take a look at them. You guys, we have learned a lot, and hopefully you have too. And remember, I'm asking you to start using that vocabulary in your everyday life. Even if it's just one word from that English sentence, even if you just simply use the word mano, or we use the word tiempo, you name it, please go back and begin to practice those words. And I'm telling you, Spanish will continue to flow out of your vocabulary, becoming an expert. So you guys, we've been using the same book this last 6 weeks or 6 lessons, and always go back. If you have not watched one of the other ones before, please go back. That way you can have some idea of what is happening in the story. I also introduced you to some depth and complexity icons, which this one is the main idea. So if you remember that the top triangle is where we put the big idea, and then our supporting details down here. Here's my Spanish generalización or idea central, and then there's my English big idea. And so we were trying to figure out what is the big idea here in this story of Lucas and his local beans. And we could say this: the big idea is that he is visiting grandpa and learning something new. The big idea could also be that exploring can lead you to new things, right? That could be the big idea as well. So whatever it is that you feel the big idea or the central idea, you just simply have to go back and support it with some of the details. So we can go back into the story and learn, yes, he, by exploring, you do get to learn new things. Also, we can tell that he loves his grandpa spending time with him, because we can always go back and look for the detalles or the details. So here in this icon, we can put Lucas here in the picture, and then we can give details about Lucas. What is specifically about Lucas? Or we can put the details here of grandpa, and then you can tell me some of the details, the attributes. What does he look like? What does he wear? How does he speak? What is his likes or dislikes about abuelo? Or we can put in here, the local beans, the jumping beans, and then we can have the details about it. So this is the details flower. Now, the language of the discipline, when you see those lips, we're simply becoming experts. If we were studying this book about the farming and about as a scientist, we're looking at nature, we're looking at animals, what kind of language would a scientist use when they're studying animals, or in this case, insects? Or what kind of language would a farmer use when they're working out with their farm? So there's a lot that we have just simply pulled from just this one book. And last week we looked at how, when you put the beans in your hand, the warmth of your beans, what does it do? Yeah, it makes them jump, right? And the beans in su mano. Remember, we looked at these words last week, and again, if you need to go back, please do so. And then Lucas asked grandpa a question. Do you remember that? What did he ask? Yeah, if can I bring these beans, to show my friends? But grandpa was honest. He said, here the weather is perfect for jumping beans to grow. If they grow in otros lugares, I really don't know. So today, let's go ahead and get started with our final part 6 of this lesson in this book. I truly have enjoyed it. So let's look at our vocabulary first. And again, you're going to repeat after me, and then let's look at the translation. Y ustedes que están aprendiendo inglés, repitan la parte de inglés conmigo. Muy bien. First word is y. Very simple, right? Y, which means and. This is when you're joining, a conjunction, when you're joining two things. I love to play soccer. Y basketball, right? Y, that's an easy one. Luna, can you repeat? Luna, good. It means moon. That's something that we can start using and practicing, Luna. Here's a phrase, muy tarde. You repeat that, muy tarde. One more time, muy tarde. Simply means very late, muy tarde. You know, Nick, in the morning, mom, dad, let's go. We got to go to school because we're going to be muy tarde. Here's the next one, yo. Repeat it, yo. Yeah, very simple, yo, which means I, yo. No, it's not yo, it's yo. Me, repeat it, me, it's mine, my. For example, the little girl's holding a muñeca or a doll, it's my, mi muñeca, me. My. Escuela. One more time. Escuela, which means school. So I wonder how, and again, we did this last week, which is great. As we go through the words, I wonder how he is using them, how the book is using them in, you know, throughout the story. Here's the last one. Compartir. You guys say it. Compartir. One more time. Compartir. Compartir, compartir, that means to share, compartir. Hey brother, I will compartir, I will share with you, compartir. All right, so let's get right into the story and let's see how they use these last couple of words and phrases. Now, if you remember, you know, Lucas just asked Grandpa, can I take these back home? So it says, we got back muy tarde. Remember, muy tarde means very late. The moon lighting our way. I was dusty and thirsty, but I had a great day. There's the moon or luna. And you see there's the word e, the conjunction e. He was dusty, e, thirsty. So again, there's e, which means and, luna, which means moon, and then muy tarde, which means very late. So again, those are the words there. Look at some of the details of Grandpa's house. Very simple. It's almost camouflage, right? It's almost, almost disappears within the land. But I love the mountains. It's one of the things that I love about traveling back to Mexico. I love just seeing the mountains. Or those of you who are from up north or on the west side, even in Austin, there's some beautiful hills out there. Oh, we come to the conclusion. I love my abuelo. I look forward to school, escuela. Sharing these jumping beans will be very cool. So will he take the jumping beans? He will. And he's going to share them or compartir. And let's just make a prediction. What do you think he's going to tell his friends? What kind of things is he going to share to his friends with about his trip? Yeah, I'm sure too. I'm sure he will be sharing about how Grandpa, you know, kind of told him the story when he was young, and I'm sure he's gonna talk about how he just jumped back whenever he saw these beans just jump around. So there are the words, yo, which means I, me, which is my, escuela, school, and compartir. Say it one more time, compartir. Well, we've come to the conclusion. We've come to the last part of the story. We've learned a lot of words. So this week, the words that I already said will be on the board. But down beneath it, the second slide that you're going to see in this Google slides, it's going to be all of the words, all of the vocabulary that we've learned so far. And I want you just to see it, practice it, repeat it. And more than anything, try to use it in your just normal day talk. Instead of saying school, try saying escuela. Instead of saying my, go ahead and say me. Me. It's mi escuela. It's my school. All right, boys and girls, we will see you the next week. Remember that if you have not seen any of the other lessons, please go back, check them out, and more than anything, practice, 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 practice. Hasta luego, adiós, nos vemos.